anyway, little do they know, they're sitting on a ticking time bomb.
Zombies on the pump.
The Walking Dead.
Oh, shit. Oh, you ain't got a zombie. You got a zombie?
Yeah, I got
one. Oh, you do got one?
They're the same one.
I
got to
get
had.
You some fringes, though.
I know. I got to get Charles on there.
We
like
got
that.
An extra one, though, the crib. I didn't know you had one.
I try to do my own little fringes.
Oh, it's all blue anyway.
Yeah, cut this and try to do my own little fringes. I'm trying to get some blue border like that. I'm just don't know how to sell those. I try to do my own little thing. I ain't finished though.
It's all good. You got a lot of demons out there. They be like, if you ain't wearing fringes every day of the week, you gonna burn.
Yeah, cause these motherfuckers, there's some niggas out there that actually send their kids to school playing basketball with fringes on and shit. And the whole school be making fun of them and shit, man. Man, you don't do no kids like that, man. That's some fucking torture.
Scripture said be harmless. Harmless as doves and wise as serpents. Wise as serpents and harmless
as a serpent, harmless as a dove.
That's right. You gotta be
not
wise.
A goddamn idiot. God damn, that's the Judite.
What's up, Judith? Right, how y'all doing?
Master is the Esau, the Judite woman.
Esau's middle man.
I gotta get my Bible out. Hold on. Hey, Paul, you wanna do this? Go hold this for a minute. I'll get my Bible.
So, you Jew bastard.
I got a 12 tribe card. Hold on. My Bible.
It feels so good. Right. It feels so goddamn good to know that this guy is coming to the end. Get him.
Hey, y'all know America's about to be destroyed.
Yeah, don't speak when you walk past us.
They laugh at that. Y'all know North Korea about to fuck you faggots up, man. You know North Korea about to fuck all you American faggots up, man. North Korea said numerous times they about to nuke America. And y'all laugh at it. Actually, these people don't even watch the news.
Right.
They don't even know
news.
About...
What's news mean?
They don't even know about North Korea. Here it is, all the Chinese is mobilizing troops on their border.
Nope.
Y'all watch the news
at all?
I live right here, Red.
You too goddamn proud?
You know North Korea about to fuck America
up? Don't you know there's a reality going on?
I don't live around here.
I live around here.
West Virginia?
They're from the goddamn hills, but they
y'all commit incest down where you from, boy.
Hey, Moab.
Moab.
Hey, you know we love King John Un over here.
You Chinese?
King John Ung.
They can't even speak English. All these damn heathens walk around like they don't know what the fuck's going on. A heathen is a heathen. There's not much you can do with a heathen. A heathen is a goddamn heathen. What are you supposed to do with a heathen? What's up, baby? You believe in Jesus?
Hey, excuse me. Why do you look like a zombie?
Because she got her snow boots on. She thinks she an Indian. She thinks she an Eskimo. She got snow boots. That's that new hot style. All these hoes now, every woman now, they wear that tight-ass black pants with some snow boots or something.
Whole gear.
Yeah, some hoe gear.
That's what it is.
Think they hot.
Hoe gear. Hoe gear. What's up, man? You watching the news?
Watch the news?
You see what's going on with North Korea? Hey, check it out, man. You know these comedians are
EMTs. He ain't totally stupid.
What? America's being hooked.
And what you gonna do when the whole country out of electric power and you got a bunch of crazy niggas chasing at you? What you gonna do then? I mean, we okay with all that. I can talk like that. It's my home.
There's gonna be a few calls. It's gonna be used for a few. It's just a word.
Because when the electric goes out, when there ain't no electricity, it's gonna be race war. Okay, when the shit hits the fan, you gonna have race war. You gonna have that. That's gonna be that's part of reality. That's what's coming.
Where does it say in the Bible that we can't fight electrically?
That's in the script. He got a scripture for you.
So, Gooks, are you all gay lovers?
Because you know, the Bible, the Lord said he came to divide. He didn't come to bring everybody together. He came, the Lord came to cause division. The Lord is all about division. Okay? Dividing one against another, man. That's what a lot of people don't understand about the Bible. The Lord, oh, go ahead. I got a scripture to back you up. Whatever you got. I'm going to get Exodus 15:3.
America, that's America's
here. Oh.
Thermonuclear missile. It's been prophesied.
Get up close upon him,
will
you?
You don't say thermonuclear missile.
So you can get a camera, so the mic can pick him up.
He ain't talking loud enough. This is where I always stand.
They didn't look up and they was looking up. They didn't say, oh, thermonuclear missile. People read. I mean, they're not looking up. Especially like, for example, like the word cloud. They don't go in the Hebrew or the Latin or the Greek to look up the cloud as you okay? Cloud ain't some goddamn fluffy ass fucking thing that's never been born. Cloud means something. But anyway, I'm trying to get that scripture for you. A missile scripture. You want a missile scripture?
Yeah. Yeah, there's many missile scriptures. Did the Lord tell you many times? But look, the Lord, how did the Lord destroy the earth at first with Noah? He destroyed the earth by water. With the flood, he destroyed the earth by fire.
That's not literally true, though.
No, it is literally true. Because now he's going to literally destroy the earth. First, he literally destroyed the earth by water.
It's allegorical. It's just a story.
No, no, no.
It's true.
How much of the percentage of the earth is covered by water? 2/3 of the earth is covered by water. The whole, the Pacific Ocean covers over half the earth. So the earth was flooded, there's no doubt about that, okay? Because the majority, the majority of the earth is covered in water.
You couldn't talk to scientists about that.
But what is what does the word science mean?
Science is like trying to find truth.
No, what does the word science mean? What does it mean? It's a Latin word. What does the Latin word science mean?
Just because they don't know what it means in Latin.
No, the Latin word sky, there's a Latin word called scientia, and that means knowledge. So the word science just means knowledge. That's all it means. Nothing more, nothing less.
To know.
It means to know, okay?
By the best means possible.
Right.
But the best means possible is not looking in like religious texts
but
for answers to
today's problems. Well, we don't have a religion. The Bible is not a religious text.
It is religious.
What does the word religious mean? The word religious, it means to bind back, to hold back, and constrain. The Holy Bible is not a religious text. This is a prophetic text. It's a historical text, okay? It's a book of laws, statutes, and commandments. Nowhere in the Bible, put it this way, when Moses was on Mount Sinai, when he gave the law to the Israelites, he never gave them religion. He gave them laws and commandments. Never once did he say, thou must follow this religion. He never said that. He said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul. He never said to follow this religion or that religion. The Bible's not religion. See,
it's Jewish. It's
no, 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 no. See, Jew comes from the word Judah, which is one tribe of the 12 tribes of Israel. See, there are 12 tribes. Jew is just one tribe of many. There are 12 tribes. That's another misconception. Because reading that scripture, bro.
The word religion itself means to hold back, to restrain.
Yep.
You know,
restrain what?
From truth.
Religion is control. Religion is control. It's servitude. It's oppression. It's slavery. That's where religion is, the way to subjugate somebody. Okay. We don't have religion. The Bible is not religion. The Bible is a book of freedom and not religion. That's what it is. All these fake ass Christians out here, all these homosexuals, these effeminate, limp-wristed Christians out here, they got the spirit of a homosexual and they got the spirit of a woman on them, okay?
Why are you a homophobe?
I'm not a homophobe. What does phobe mean? What does phobe mean?
But I'm not afraid of gay people.
No, not being afraid.
You sound like a gay person.
Not being afraid of them, man.
Phobe means afraid. We're not afraid of faggots. There's nothing to be afraid of.
We'll
a fact.
We'll find you hate gay people.
No, we don't.
Well, apparently you
Well,
do.
We do hate them. Yes, we do. We do hate them. You're
That's
correct.
Ridiculous.
We do hate them.
Like, it means you're a bigot.
No, no, we're not a bigot.
Yeah, well, it sounds like you are.
If you love him so much, why don't you go plug him in the ass?
No, because we don't. Hold on. Let me show you something. Let me show you something real quick.
She's going to.
Let me show you something. Can you tell me what it say? What does it say?
This place gotta go.
What does this sign say right here? Read that real
people
good.
People like you got my fucking daughter thinking being a faggot is normal.
You catching diseases.
Right.
Read this
That's
sign.
That's insanitary as hell.
What does this sign say?
Well,
these are government statistics. What does it say? Over half of the American population is infected with STDs and venereal diseases. That's a government statistic.
And that's because of gay people.
Well, gay people and adultery. Yes, that's half of that.
But gay people aren't spreading this straight.
But hold, they're not gay though. They're homosexual.
They're sexual.
They're not gay. Gay means happy and joyous.
Homosexual.
Gay means happy. There's nothing happy about your ass being on fire.
Homosexual people were responsible for that. Like, how are they transmitting it to straight people?
Because they're
Bisexual freaks. Because they're bisexual.
Men and women.
They have sex with men and women. And women like a feminine men now.
Have always existed.
It has not always existed.
That's how you know this is safe.
Okay, all right.
They fight for that shit.
It has always existed.
Fight for that shit.
You know the story is.
Damn well. You probably don't even think that shit's normal.
What happened to Sodom and Gomorrah? You're right. Homosexuals were in the ancient world. Now tell me, what did God do to the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah?
That's a story.
That he destroyed them by fire. But do you know archaeologists have found proof?
I can believe what I want to believe.
What's your nationality?
Faggot.
Of course.
Your dad's side?
I'm both sides.
You're both sides?
Yeah.
So he probably an Israelite.
I don't think he is.
Well, he could be Edomite. Well, I'm saying.
Yeah, definitely Edomite.
The real Irish. Put it this way. The real Irish, if you're a real Irishman, which we have in serious doubts about right now, if you're a real Irishman, the real Irishmen are Israelite.
I'm American.
A real Irishman fears the Lord.
You know what America means?
Well, I mean, like, it's the.
You know what the word America means?
He don't know shit.
Yeah, but the word America, what does it mean?
It actually means bitter.
It means, right, bitter.
It comes from a Hebrew word that means bitter. Because, first of all, if you call yourself an Irishman, the real, you know who St. Patrick is? St. Patrick was a real Irishman, and he feared the most. If St. Patty was here today, he would be cursing these demons out. He'd be calling them a bunch of faggots.
He'd be killing them.
Happy as hell.
Okay.
You
gonna tell me St. Patty was okay with faggots? You gonna tell me he was okay with adultery? Oh,
those
hell no.
Already existed, like, and homosexuality is not.
Shut the fuck up.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
But actually, no. Homosexuality far surpasses the wickedness of adultery.
Homosexuality doesn't hurt anybody.
Yes, it does.
So
actually,
it drives up insurance rates. What are you fucking talking about?
Do you know that homosexuality is unsanitary? You know that? So let me ask you a question. What is so scientific about a man busting a nut up in another man's ass and laying sperm up inside of his ass?
That's an infection.
Now, what is sperm for? Tell me, explain to me what sperm is and what the purpose of sperm is.
The devil got y'all gas.
Sperm creates life. And fertilize, does a man have an egg? So tell me, what kind of scientific truth is in a man putting sperm up in another man's ass? What kind of sense does that make scientifically?
I'm not saying it leads to, conception, but
it leads to diseases.
It doesn't hurt anyone.
Read the sign. It does hurt people.
It doesn't hurt anyone.
Actually, like the brother said, homosexuality is driving up insurance rates.
He's
a faggot.
You saw that, didn't you? But you did see that.
And he's a homosexual.
You did see that.
He looks like people have been busting shots all over your face.
He noticed that homo looking at him like he liked him.
You like busting up in another man's ass?
From experience.
Is that good?
You like getting your asshole blown out?
I seen it back home.
Yeah, oh yeah.
You get 10 homosexuals, they will fucking rape you, man.
They
will rape you, period. And now, you said, that's not a problem?
Don't you know Russia just passed? Look,
rape a lot of people.
You know who Putin is? You know who Putin got? You know who the president? You know who Putin is, the president of Russia? He just passed a law in Russia that said homosexual foreign couples are no longer allowed to adopt Russian children because the American homosexuals going over to Russia adopting children and they're raping them and they're fucking them in the ass.
No, it's not true. Like,
it is true. It is true.
I know exactly what happened. He said that no American couples can adopt Russian children.
Why is that?
It's
because they're molesting them and fucking them in the ass.
No. It's because the United States passed laws like saying that Russians cannot purchase land here in the
United States. Not true. Because Russia also just passed another law that outlawed homosexual propaganda. Russia said that this is Russia. This is not Sodom and Gomorrah.
That's what he said.
That's a direct quote. So the Russians, they look down upon America because America... Look, read this sign. Read this.
Russia has any, like...
There's a bunch of people down on
us. Can you read...
It's an extremely oppressive place to live.
Can you read...
Let me read something.
Oh, go ahead.
This is homosexual behavior, medically inferior. Even if we ignore the issues of procreation, the evidence shows that homosexual...
Where is this from?
This is off the CDC website.
This CDC.
Is CDC. Let's see. I'm going to
the link. I'm reading right here.
What? Hold up.
Show me the link to see this. The Center for Disease Control.
Let me just read this. I'll show you.
What do you think this is right here? This sign right here. No. This sign right here, these numbers. Over 110 million Americans are infected with venereal diseases.
These are statistics from
the CDC.
That's not because of homosexuality.
No, it's from a combination of homosexuality and adultery. It's a combination of the two.
And adultery. So people just get like STIs and STDs from like cheating on their spouse.
From having more than one sexual partner, which is an abomination. Woman is only supposed to be with
Where's
one
your credible source? We need a credible source on that.
As many women as you want.
As long as she don't have.
As long as she's clean. As long as she's a virgin.
How are men supposed to do that? The women only have one partner. How is that? How are you guys supposed to do that?
Because there's more. How many women are there? Is like four women to each man on the planet Earth.
No, there's not.
Yes, there is. That's a fact. Google it. Google how many men are there to women on the planet. There's at least a 4-to-1 ratio. At least.
I believe it.
At least.
Shit.
Hold on, let me hear that.
That's why in China, a baby boy. They love it because if they have a baby, if they have a give birth to a female, they'll kill it and have an abortion.
China has an unequal sex ratio because it's advantageous. Like before, like they have one child policy. It's advantageous to have a male so he can pass your property.
But you know, soon they're gonna turn America. America's the new China. You know that, right? They bring the communism to America. Yes, they are. America is communist. It's in the early stages of communism.
Nope.
As soon as it's going to be all out communism. Well,
if America's in the early stages of communism, we better be in the early stages of communism.
The fact that all this shit's going on.
Guys, we've had like Social Security since 1933. That's pretty communist.
You just admitted Social Security is communist.
I'm old by your definition of communism. But like it's a program that like, yes, Americans pay into. But like, benefits all society. But like it's not like we're just like, we just got programmed.
Do you believe in the Bible? You know, we don't really give a damn about America. We believe in the Bible over here, all right? And I got a scripture for you. Let me read this. Leviticus 20:10. Now, this is the
sacred... I'm already there, bro.
Do you believe in the Ten Commandments? Now, look, the Ten Commandments is the most sacred of all the laws. Is the Ten Commandments is the most holy of the holy. The least your wicked ass could do is keep the Ten Commandments, okay? Now listen to me. The Ten Commandments says, thou shalt not commit adultery. Okay, now let me read this to you. Leviticus 20:10. And a man that committeth adultery with another man's wife, even he that committeth adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer and the adulteress shall surely be put to death. And the man that lieth with his father's wife has uncovered his father's nakedness. Both of them shall surely be put to death. Their blood shall be upon them. And if a man... In America, there's no punishment for that.
Pretty much is common sense.
Let me skip down to 13.
I think it's bad to share in your heart.
Now, let me skip down to verse 13. Listen.
That's what adultery is.
This is the Holy Bible. The holy of the holy, the most sacred of the sacred. Now, listen. No, to no, this
yeah,
is.
You're right.
You're right. Now listen, if a man also lied with mankind, this is Leviticus 20 and 13. If a man also lied with mankind, as he lieth with a woman, meaning he fucking a man in the ass, right? Both of them have committed an abomination. They shall surely be put to death.
We don't need to look up words and find out what abomination means, right?
Their blood shall be upon them.
That speaks for itself.
That's the Bible.
There's reasons for that. Now, that's it goes down to the cellular.
Let me get this one straight.
This goes deeper and much deeper. Than
hold on. What's the fucking Teamsters? You part of some Freemasonic temple?
Oh, he part of the Teamsters.
Yeah. Look
he
at his
tag. He down with Jimmy Hoffa and them. Oh, he down with Obama. Because Obama's a Teamster. That Teamster's another, that's a code word for communist. And that's what a Teamster's a communist.
You look like a big commie.
A Teamster is a socialist. He's a communist. That's what a Teamster is. A union. The union means the same thing as communion. Communion. Union. Communist. Unionist. Communist union. You're a communist. You're a communist. You might as well go join the USSR.
You're union dues and everything.
I'm not in it.
You're not? I'm just.
Well, you got a Teamster's hat on your head.
Straight up, just wearing the hat.
No, now he's lying. He's a fuck. This dude's a fucking fed. He's like government agent or something.
Nah. He's no agent.
So you guys like just choosing on a weeb, like don't take my word for anything.
We don't take shit, you say.
No, you don't trust me.
Of course I don't trust you, because you're not teaching the words of the Father. If you're not coming in the spirit of the Heavenly Father, we don't trust you. I got a scripture for you.
Let me get this script real quick.
Go ahead.
You are
this is,
oh, he got a scripture.
That don't bother you at all?
Hey, hold up. The brother got a scripture.
I can play Wall Street.
You think it's good they're out there and they're complaining about having degrees, but they can't find work?
That's not exactly what it is. Like,
Occupy Wall Street.
A lot of different economic issues. Like, we have a growing inequality.
Occupy Wall Street was set up by the Obama administration.
No, you know, like, it's like, I mean, of course, like, it's just getting worse.
Occupy Wall Street's like, set up, bro.
Well, listen, that's all the growth of the past 40 years has gone to the top 1% of
those.
Whereas, like, middle class wagers, their wages are stagnant. In the past 40 years, in the mid-70s, they've not grown. Whereas the incomes as well, while people making over $250,000 a year, have skyrocketed.
Let me ask you, I got a good point to make. All the leaders of Occupy Wall Street and all that, a lot of them are women and homosexuals. Read this.
What's wrong with the women?
Because women ain't if you got a woman leading you, that tells you how weak you are and how soft you are.
No, that doesn't.
Because a woman ain't supposed to lead nothing but the cookies and the pies. Read this. Listen to this. No, bro, you got to listen. You got to get.
Through a system that was instituted in this world.
What does woman's lib mean? You know what the word lib means? In the women's lib, you know about women's lib? So-called women's lib don't mean liberation. When you look the word lib up in a Webster's unabridged universal dictionary, the word lib means to castrate. That's what it means. To castrate. Now hold on, let me read this for you. Now listen to this. This is key.
This is Romans 1 and 26. For this cause God gave them up unto foul affection.
A lot of these leaders Occupy Wall Street, they got vow affection. They're homosexual. Keep going.
So like the Tea Party is
better. Or even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature.
Yeah, the Tea Party, a lot of the Tea Party people like Glenn Beck, they bunch of faggots too. Keep going.
And likewise also the men leaving the natural use of the woman.
What's the natural use of a woman? What's a woman's purpose? You plant your seed in that woman so your seed can grow. Your seed can't grow in a man's hairy ass. Okay, so keep going.
And let's discuss the use of the woman burn.
You gotta say it like this.
One toward the other.
I'm with you, bro.
Men with men.
That's disgusting.
Working that which is unseemly.
So when a man's got his dick in another man's ass,
it's
that's disgusting. Unseemly.
It's saying the same thing. It's disgusting.
It's unseemly. We means it's not natural. It's unnatural.
Listen,
I'm not as worried about laws like banning homosexuality.
And receiving in themselves.
Scripture says to kill them. Scripture says to kill them.
Of their error.
The recompense of the error.
Scriptural authority for what? Like, we should, for a law.
It's because
why would you want to take up for a faggot? If you take up for a faggot, that makes you a faggot.
Because, I'm not totally selfish. I can, step in other people's shoes and, see their vanity. because they're different people.
And you see, what the point is though, you've been raised up in an effeminate, homosexual society, and you've been raised up to accept it. So you've been conditioned to accept it like that's normal. Fucking a man in the ass and getting dick on your, getting doo-doo on your dick is normal. You know what I'm saying? Going up another man's ass is normal now.
I don't think it's normal. It's always going on. It's just that you don't address it.
Right. What the scripture says, the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. It's the wicked who's controlling shit that's allowing.
That's running this shit.
But this control is only for a short amount of time.
There's nothing you can do to stop it.
Oh, wait. There's going to be a divine intervention.
The order of balance will be restored.
Let me ask you a question. You
the order of balance is going to be restored.
Do you believe in the one they call Jesus?
You can see it. This place is going down.
Do you or do you not believe in the one?
Society's advanced like...
No. The hell society. Society's going to be destroyed. Do you believe in Jesus?
He exists.
You believe he exists?
Yeah.
All right, that's the starting point. But do you believe he's the son of the Most High?
No.
And so you don't believe in the son of God. So that makes you an antichrist and a heathen. You know that?
And the Romans thought that their religion was going to be forever.
Yeah, the Romans thought...
You sound just like a Roman.
Yeah, he is a Roman. He's a Latin.
I don't think the United States is going to last forever. I don't think like any particular civilization is going to last forever. But society has made a lot of progress.
They really think America is going to last forever.
Human society has its problems. Like, definitely. And a lot of people are born into poverty and hardship and have, very hard lives.
There's a system there. In place.
The system is an experience.
I'm sure it has something to do with it. But, the system...
That Jesus is the Christ, you said he's not the Christ. You said he's not the Son of God. Whoever believeth that Jesus is the Christ is born of God. So you're not born of God. Everyone that loveth him, that begot, loveth him also that is begotten of him.
So what he's doing right now, he's marking. Okay, there's a mark that, when the end times come, some people gonna have that mark in their mind that, I embrace the word when I heard it. And there are those that embrace it. That rejected the word.
You can't use scriptural authority to convince somebody.
This is authority.
If you're trying to convince me of something like
that. Oh no, we already know you're a non-believer.
We already know you. I got a script.
We already know.
First John 5.
We're just trying to get you to go away.
Watch this. I'm gonna show you something.
No, not into this truth.
Do you know that you are in the Bible? The Lord thought so highly about you that he put you in the scripture.
People are talk about it in general.
Watch, I got a scripture for you. 1 John 5:10. He that believeth on the Son of God, you said Jesus is not the Son of God. He that believeth on the Son of God hath the witness in himself.
That's a bad scripture.
He that believeth not God hath made him a liar, because he believeth not the record that the God gave his son.
There you go. That's self-explanatory.
Come on, bro. You gonna reject the Son of God? You gonna reject the Son of God, right?
I just honestly don't believe in the Son of God.
So you don't believe his prophecy?
He don't believe in
you. How is that convincing? You haven't proved anything. You just read from that book.
It's a word of the Most High.
Man, he's just carnal, man. That hungry.
You're carnal.
He's just carnal as hell.
You ain't gonna believe that the Son of God is real unless he comes down here by himself.
If I can't be converted, how did the early Christians be converted?
You can't be converted. You was chosen for destruction.
So nobody in history has converted somebody else to religion.
Well, no.
Actually, because people can't
this
think
this
that.
Everybody's going to say it's not religion.
The scriptures say if we was chosen, if we was chosen before the earth was even formed. I got a scripture for that.
That's that fucking Edomite.
But this
shit.
Isn't religion.
That bullshit philosophy. That everybody thinking about philosophy.
Science and philosophy are not bullshit.
Science is not. Bible science.
Philosophy means the lover.
Yeah, philosophy means lover of wisdom.
Right. Everybody going off
Philae
of
plus
opinion.
Sophia.
It ain't about what opinion is. It's about what truth is truth.
I got a scripture for you, though. To prove that there's no... I got a scripture for you to prove.
You deal with opinions.
Yeah.
There's no
system. Sounds like you guys
are
arguing about it.
So
it's just your opinion that
there's no
opinion. This book
is an authority, but to me it's not an authority.
Everything we're talking about is
cool. But your opinion really don't matter. Ephesians 1
4.
I don't have an opinion.
But it's not his opinion. He's reading the scripture.
I say this here.
But he's reading the scripture. How can it be his opinion when he's reading?
Why? Ephesians.
Yeah, no, it's his opinion that
this has been here. It is, put it this way. This Bible was here long before you were born, and it will be here long after you are gone. Everybody will remember the Bible, but they will not remember you. Now listen to this. Ephesians 1 and 4. According as he hath chosen us and him before the foundation of the world. We was chosen before the earth was even formed. That we should be holy and without blame before him in love, having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Jesus Christ to himself according to the good pleasure of his will. So everything is predestinated.
Okay?
There is no such thing as free will. There is no free will. If you think you have free will, you're a fool. You're a robot. You're a programmed robot who performs the functions of his program.
Yeah, sure, pretty
that's
much.
What you do.
That's what everybody
I mean, like,
does.
These are similar to machines.
And everybody.
We are
but
all
I
the
still
same.
Make choices.
You have make no choices.
I do make choices.
You make no choices.
Yeah, I chose this
dude. Oh, really? You make choices? Hey, give me John.
Why don't you choose to walk away then?
Yeah, choose to walk away. Watch this.
Actually, we're waiting for you to.
And you got no choice. You gotta go to work.
That's why you're here, so it's totally
you have to go to work.
You want me to walk away.
You gotta pay your bills.
We do.
You gotta go to work. You gotta go pay your bills.
I got one for you.
You guys, like, insulting people are trying to convince us now.
And what does red letters mean? You know what red letters mean? What does that mean? It's red letters. It means that the one you call Jesus is speaking. His real ancient Hebrew, you speak Hebrew? His real ancient Hebrew name is Yahweh Shai, not Jesus.
Okay?
Jesus is an English name.
Sweet Jesus.
But listen to this. For your free will. Let's listen to what the Lord said about free will. John 16 and, actually, my fault. John 15 and 16.
Wait, hold on a second. Did you guys believe that the world was going to come to an end in December?
No. It doesn't fucking matter.
No, I don't even believe in that shit.
What he's referring to is the world.
He said
the
December.
The world is referring to a certain
2012
nation.
Been passed.
It's a certain nation he was referring to, not the whole.
Like, we would admit that if we did believe it. Like, it's past.
You know, like, these niggas in the hood, they in their own world. You can't even relate to them if you hung out with them for a year. You still won't be able to relate to them. But they're in their own world, and they can't relate to you.
But
okay, so there's different worlds.
There's different worlds.
When the world comes to an end, it's talking about a different nation. It's a certain nation.
You guys are very selectively. You are very selectively interpreting.
Watch this.
Because guys, like,
well, how do we agree? How can we know the same thing?
As prediction after prediction, like, does not happen. It's not like the world is not going to come to an end.
You're right.
The world's
not going to come to an end.
Never going
to
come to
an end. You're right. The world's not going to come.
So where's all the people that agree with you?
Another certain thing, but you're saying that, like, right here, this is going to come to an end. When this doesn't,
no, America,
yeah, this kingdom is going to be destroyed.
America, this kingdom right here, this piece of filth is going to be destroyed. Now, I'm going to prove to you that there's no free will. Watch this. John 15 to 16. This is the Lord speaking. Now, listen, it's red letters.
It's
now,
physics.
Look. Now, if you listen to us, you might actually learn
hold
something.
On for a second, but if I'm an atheist and I don't accept that God exists, then you can't use the word of God to convince me.
I don't care. I don't care.
First, you need to convince me that God exists. Then you can use this word.
It doesn't matter what you believe.
Let me just read this one.
Let me read this first. Let me read this one. Then you get that.
Hey, you just got
to
see it.
John 15 to 16. This is the Lord speaking. Red letters. He said, ye have not chosen me. He said, ye have not chosen me. So it's not your choice. You don't have, there's no choice.
There goes one of your Teamster buddies right there.
Hold on, hold on. Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. He said, the Lord has chosen you. He's talking to us, not you. And ordained you that you should go forth and bring fruit. Bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain. That whatsoever you shall ask of the Father in my name,
not Jesus, sweet Jesus,
he may give it to you. So the Lord say he chose us. We ain't choosing. There's no choice. There is no choice.
Let me give you this.
There's only the illusion of choice.
Ecclesiastes 1:4. One generation passes away, and another generation comes.
Yep.
But the earth abides forever.
That's Ecclesiastes the first chapter. So the earth abides forever. So nowhere in the Bible does that say the earth is going to be destroyed. You don't say that.
It's a nation that's going to be destroyed.
Nation?
And you're saying it's the United States.
No, it's a nation. It's a so-called people.
The Edomites.
The so-called white man.
He's
going into slavery for 1,000 years.
And his nation is America.
We're going to whoop his ass for 1,000 years.
How is that going to happen?
How? We're going to put him in slavery.
You ever heard of Have you ever heard of
the same way they put us in slavery?
Let me ask you a question.
You physically come take a man over.
Have you ever heard of
Do you have a plan to do that?
Heavenly Father. Nuclear missiles. Have you ever heard of thermonuclear missiles?
Yes, I've heard of them.
Now, do you know about North Korea threatening the United States? Have you heard about it? It's been in the news all week.
North Korea is a petty minor power. They can't do anything.
That's that proud spirit.
That's the problem.
Hey, give me give me Psalms 49, bro.
You got that Roman spirit. Like
get Psalms 49 and 11.
2 million air jets.
They have nukes.
A missile defense system that would destroy
it. Oh, don't you know how missile defense,
system are outdated?
Yeah,
hey, look,
America don't have the money to update them.
America has no problem borrowing money.
That's why they're $60 trillion.
From whom? Who are they getting that money from? Not America.
Your debt. Wait a minute. Let's just say it this way: inflation. It keeps inflating and inflating. Eventually, what it does?
Inflation actually decreases the value of that.
Back during World War II, a comic book cost 10 cents. Now a comic book costs $5.
But there's also an increase in the money supply.
He got a scripture for you. Read a scripture. Yeah.
Money is not what you print.
Psalms, let me read a scripture.
Psalms 49.
That's not money, man.
Psalms, just read real loud.
You keep printing RFI.
Hey, Chan, he got a scripture.
Psalms 49 and 11.
You said North Korea can't do nothing?
Their inward thoughts is that their houses shall continue forever.
You say your inward thoughts is your houses, your neighborhoods, and your cities.
Your country.
And your way of
your
life.
Nation.
Your nation is going to continue. Read it again.
Their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever and their dwelling places to all generations. They call their lands after their own names.
They call America, America is not the original name of this continent. Okay, Native American Indians did not call America America. America
came in,
they changed the names of all the land. Just like when they sacked Constantinople over there in Turkey, they changed the name. The Turks, which were goddamn Edomites, which were white people, they changed the name of Constantinople to Istanbul. They changed the name. Just like when they came to America, a lot of the Native American Indians called Native America Colonel King, and they changed the name to America. This ain't the name. The name of America is named after Amerigo Vespucci, a goddamn Italian, a Latin.
Edomite.
So that's why
Nobody here came from his balls.
That's why that scripture says.
So how can you be American?
Right. You guys, if you're looking to enslave white people, why don't you do it in the same way that the Europeans did? You just do it in the real world.
That was y'all time.
Not wait for
Nations
fall, nations rise. It was y'all time to rise.
We ain't worried about, the devil.
You yourself?
No. They're going to go into slavery regardless. It ain't got to do with what we want to do.
It's not going to happen unless you do it yourself.
That's where you're going.
That's what we're waiting for. We're waiting for the Lord. When he gets here,
Europeans didn't wait for God to do it.
It's all about patience.
You will go into slavery by our own.
Hey, give me the Apocrypha. Give
y'all
me
did it.
Give me Judith 9:11. You got an Apocrypha?
It was all about the time.
I got it.
Nations rise, nations fall. It was all time to rise.
Enslave,
no, I got a scripture for
yourself.
We're going to.
If everybody woke the fuck up.
When the Lord gets you,
you're it ain't about white
people. Payback.
The Edomites are getting the
you gotta pay for what your forefathers did, period.
You're more than capable of doing it yourself, man. You don't have to wait for God to
I got a scripture for you.
The Lord said to wait for him.
Does not save by a shield and by a spear. Okay? The Lord does not save. I got a scripture for you. Judith 9:11. This is Judith. This is what we call the 911 scripture.
Dude, why would black people enslave
that? Well, listen. I'm going to read a scripture for you.
Because this book was given to us because this book is law. As soon as you run into the as soon as you go off the track,
so people.
And if anything, like, every people didn't weren't exposed to
shit. Hold on, I got a scripture for you.
And, like, sometimes every people can't be held responsible for that.
Well, actually, like,
that's
why
the Most High word.
That's why the Lord said.
That's absurd.
What did the Lord?
But in the previous life, you say you can't be held responsible. It's something they did in the previous life.
I got a scripture
but
for you.
But you got to know about reincarnation. Like, your soul was here plenty of times before.
I don't know about that.
So you don't believe
what the book of Mark says.
But there's a reason.
Because you got to prove that. You can't just use the Bible. You got to prove that reincarnation
exists. How can we prove reincarnation?
It's easy in the Bible.
I'm saying outside of the scriptures.
No, you're talking about like actual physical.
Like,
that's carnal as hell.
No, it ain't. Give me Matthew 19.
Like, we got magical powers or something.
Every time I say science, you, like, conflate.
Science means knowledge.
Using the scientific method.
What's the scientific method? Who's the great? Let me ask you a question.
Observing the natural world that we're living in right now.
Who created the scientific method? Let's take it back further than that. Give me 19 where it's about the resurrection. Okay. Hold up. Before we get to that, who the scientists consider to be the greatest scientist of all time? Sir Isaac Newton is the greatest. They built statues of him, all right? Sir Isaac Newton was a Christian. He said a Bible was 100% truth. So give me that Matthew 19, we're going to prove reincarnation.
19:28, Matthew's 19:28. And Yahweh shot, and Jesus said unto them, verily, I say unto you, that ye which have followed me in the regeneration.
Now stop, what does regeneration mean? Now, what does the word generation mean? The gene. Like, you come from your father's genes. Gene, like the book of Genesis, the beginning. Now, what does regeneration mean? The regenesis. That means to go back
that's
to the
not,
beginning.
You guys, like,
it means to be born
what I'm trying
again.
To tell you is that
read it.
I don't accept, like, the scripture before you.
Oh.
Like, just because that book says it, it doesn't mean
now you're gone, though. This proves reincarnation. Read this.
And how shall I say unto you? Verily, I say unto you, ye which have followed me in the regeneration
or the reincarnation, keep going.
When the Son of Man shall sit in the throne of his glory.
The Son of Man is not yet sitting in the throne of his glory.
Okay. Ye also shall sit upon 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel.
And he was speaking to the 12 disciples when he said it. Now all the 12 disciples never judged the 12 tribes of Israel sitting on thrones. The head disciple, Peter, he got hung upside down on the cross. Meaning the disciples were crucified and killed by the Romans. So he said in the regeneration, in the reincarnation, then you will sit on your throne and judge the 12 tribes.
If I were a Hindu, and I came up to you, and I started reading from a Hindu religious text, and I just read from it, and demanded that you believe it, why would you believe it?
The Hindus are heathens. What does the word Hindu mean?
But that's your
what
to
does
them.
The word Hindu mean? That's what the word Hindu is. Hindu, okay? The Hindus are Elamites. You know who the Elamites are? The Hindus, the Bible, they know they're Elamites too. They tell you their own writing, okay? The Elamites are the Hindus. And the Bible clearly tells you the Elamites or the Hindus are heathens. They are not the children of the promise. They are the children of the of course not. A heathen ain't gonna call himself a heathen.
But let's
break it down.
This is all relative.
Let's break it down. The Hindus worship a bunch of blue gods. They worship Shiva, who got like eight arms. You believe in Shiva? You believe in a god that is blue and got eight arms? You believe in that?
Say I was Zoroaster.
So you fucked out. First you're a Hindu, now you're a Zoroaster.
I didn't say I was a Hindu.
But now, okay, now you're...
You, situation.
But why, hold no, on, no, no, why, how come you ain't a Hindu no more? You, first you was a Hindu, now you a Zoroaster. But the Zoroastrians are also Elamites, because the Zoroastrians come from Persia, and the Persians are Elamites, just like the Hindus
but
are Elamites.
But if I'm reading from a Zoroastrian text, like...
What does the word Iran mean? Because that's what the Zoroastrians come from
okay,
Persia,
hold on a second. Okay,
which
I gotta say what I'm gonna say.
No, what does the word Iran mean?
You have plenty of time to talk.
No.
You have plenty of time to talk, but I'm done.
I'm trying to know one second. You don't know what you're talking about.
Why wouldn't you believe if I was Zoroastrian, like just reading from my book and said, here's the truth
what book?
Right here.
So what's the name of the Zoroastrian book?
I don't know.
You don't know. Hold up. You don't know the name of the Zoroastrian book, but yet you got their book. What's the name of their book?
I don't know.
Because there ain't no book.
I'm sure they have
you're making
text.
Shit up.
I'm not making.
We don't live in speculation. We don't live in fairy tale land. We do not live
in opinion land.
We don't live in imagination land. Read that.
Zechariah 4:8. Therefore, wait ye upon me, said the Lord, until the day that I rise up to the fray.
Wait upon the Lord. Now, when you see Lord in all capital letters in the King James Bible, when you read it. Because the Bible was originally written in Hebrew. When you read the Bible in the Hebrew, and when you see Lord in all caps in English in the Hebrew, that means that the word Yahweh is written in the Hebrew, which means the Most High's name. It don't say Zoroaster. It don't say any Hindu gods.
Yahweh.
Read that again.
Don't accept the authority of that text.
Well, we don't get it. Look, our belief, the truth does not require a heathen to believe.
They think the exact same thing about their text.
Well, it doesn't matter what they think.
That you're evil.
No, they're not. They don't believe that, actually.
They think that.
No, they don't. Actually, they
think
they're
like, you're infidel.
They know who the Israelites
are. Know exactly who
they know who the Israelites are.
But they don't think they like, they have the truth about God.
See, you just buck it up against it because you hate the truth. Read it again.
So if somebody disagrees with you, then they're just...
The Bible said we're supposed to all be in agreement and all the one accord.
So why
there's supposed to be no divisions among us.
So why am I disagreeing?
The Bible says, and Satan is divided against himself, how can his kingdom stand?
On top of this book, I got a part of this book.
You got a Bible and a pocket. He got a Bible and a pocket. He got a Bible. Y'all got a Bible? King James, you got a pocket? Yeah, you know what's up.
And I can't be convinced, like, God has already chosen you and they're going to heaven. Well, what's the point of it? Standing out of your tongue.
Edification for the camera, for people that watch
it. Most I like it. Most I got to be entertained too.
You know, we like entertaining ourselves.
We like to be entertained. You know? Us talking to you is entertainment to us. It's right. A good time.
Maybe for you.
You know, it ain't threatening.
We already know you ain't going to learn that.
We're going to whoop your ass. Ain't no shit like that. You know?
Yeah, we ain't
this
like that.
This is fun. This is our life, man. You know? When this end time comes, when the destruction and all this chaos start, you need to understand that, damn. There was prophets. I was in front of some prophets.
If that happens, then I will understand.
No, it ain't if. It's going to happen. It's going to happen.
If it happens, I will.
It's going to happen.
See, you had that crowd. Well,
that's what you're going to say. I'm not going to.
That's what you're going to say in your mind. Damn, I was in front of some prophets.
Egyptian said that
what?
Shit.
If?
If.
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 The comic book, what if?
Oh, what if? Yeah, there's a comic book. You ever read Marvel Comics? They had a comic book called What If. That's the shit that never happened. Go ahead. Yeah, I forgot. Yeah, Marvel.
This is some bad stories, though.
Yeah, what if?
This is some bad stories, man. What if?
Yeah, what if?
Adam Newton could beat the Hulk.
Or what if?
But the thing could never beat the Hulk.
What if Conan lived today? If Conan actually lived today, he'd be raping bitches.
Yep.
He'd be punching bitches in the face.
Yeah.
Put him over his shoulder, taking that bitch home with him. That's the spirit you're supposed to be in.
That's
you're
right.
Supposed to let a woman.
As a man, you're supposed to be.
Yeah, a woman is a piece of property. Do you believe that?
No.
See, that's you're off, man. You're totally off.
These bitches, man.
You're gone. If you don't believe you're the one with a piece of property, something's wrong with you, man. Ain't you heard the term a piece of ass? That's a property. A woman is equivalent to money. That's what a woman is, equivalent to shekels. That's right. A woman can be bought with money. Believe that?
Like in ancient times.
No, now too. I can go right now buy a prostitute.
Yeah, that's not the same thing.
It's the same exact same thing.
Your elites do it.
Yeah.
All the time.
Everybody buy women. A woman is not supposed to be a leader.
It's like buying her chattel slavery. It's buying like an hour of her time to get a sex.
The scriptures say you pay money for your wife. The scriptures say you can rape her.
It's because the Bible was written like 2,000 years ago, and back in the days when you actually did.
So you can tell me 2,000 years ago shit was different.
Yeah.
So you tell me
that's
2,000 years ago, did the sun go up and go down? It was real different.
Not
right?
Everything has changed, but a lot of things have.
What's changed? You tell me the moon.
Well, for one, you can't.
Was there a moon in a different spot 2,000 years ago? Everything was the same.
Not everything.
Damn,
was that here 2,000 years ago?
Go ahead.
Was that building here 2,000 years ago?
That's just brick. Actually, it was, because it's made out of the brick and mud of the earth.
Wait, so it was still there.
As currently constructed.
There.
As currently constructed.
It's just made of mud and brick.
As currently constructed. Now you're fucking. Yeah, you are.
I told you it was here. It was in the mud.
As currently constructed.
It's just
like
a
that.
Building.
You didn't say that.
It's just stone and brick.
You said everything is changing.
Everything is changed.
You said everything stayed the same.
Nobody cares about that building. It's not any significant.
Let me read this. Ecclesiastes 36:24.
No, I'm not.
He that getteth a wife beginneth a possession.
Read that again.
He that getteth a wife.
Read a chapter and the number.
Ecclesiastes 36:24. He that getteth a wife beginneth a possession.
So there ain't no debate. A woman's
that's
a possession.
That's why people don't listen to me.
But now they do.
That's not right.
I'm listening to it. He's listening to it. Actually, you're.